Hey, what's up all my gamers and gamettes? It's the one they call Top Diggity Dog, and I'm back with some next-gen news. Oh yeah, it's time to dominate. First up, this is for all my PC people that will be getting a PS4, but have a question on their mind, and that question is, will the PS4, aka the DualShock 4 controller, be capable to be compatible with the PC? And the answer is yes. Shuhei Yoshida has said that will be the case. However, he did say that the motion function and the touchpad function would not be available for the controller when you hook it up to your PC. It will only be basic functions like the button, the analog sticks, all that stuff that you will be able to actually do. And I'm no developer, but I have done my research on how they implement controllers for their games. Like the Xbox 360 controller and the PS3 controller work for the PC because it's pretty much just plug and play. You know, you don't have to really worry about some crazy odd feature that controller have. But I even hear developers saying for the PS4 controller specifically that they have to go in and program different things to, like, wait a minute, how can I implement the touchpad for this specific game? I heard Watch Dogs, the guy at Watch Dogs say it. He was like, they didn't really know how they was going to implement the touchpad for the PS4. They didn't know, but they finally was like, okay, wait a minute, hold on. We using phones in our game, so wait a minute. Yo, hey, man, we got an idea. Let's do that for the touchpad. Like, let's have it like when you use a phone in real life, you know? So they're still thinking about that stuff. So when you try to take that and put that to, like, say, for example, you buy Battlefield 4 for the PC because it looked better than the PS4. So you buy it for the PC instead of the PS4, and you're like, okay, I'm going to hook up my PS4 controller to my PC. Yeah, you know, the touchpad feature will not be, you know, nothing to be happening for that, for the PC. In other words, it takes special coding for them to make that controller work for that specific feature. So if you try to take it and put it into another console, like the, you know, well, not a console, but a PC, that feature is just not gonna work because it's made for that specific console. Y'all get me? Anyways, let's go ahead and hop into some Xbox One. You remember Kinect, Mr. Always Eyes on You? Well, Xbox is still trying to get you to share data with other people, such as advertisers. Now, for all these functions, they do assure you that you can turn it off, you can turn it on, do whatever, you know, you please. But man, I mean, it just, it brings up question marks popping all up in your head, like, hey, okay, I game in the noob, that's my thing, that's what I do. So I sit down in my console, play some Call of Duty, even though, yes, that sound odd. I'll sit down at my console, play some Call of Duty in the nude. I mean, will, like, the world see me do that, you know? You know, it's just a lot of things that a lot of people's not really feeling that's coming from the share. It seems like in all these articles, they're trying to get you to, hey, we offer sharing. Like, you can share that. But, you know, sharing is a beautiful thing, but only if it's done right. But it sounds like it's something that they keep on pushing, and it's so many rumors that we heard, and, you know, since the Xbox One been announced about the whole Kinect Always Online, which, yeah, it ain't there no more. That ain't the case. But it's just, you know, questions pop up in our minds. So Xbox, yeah, yeah. So for all my people that's going to get an Xbox One, and no, I'm not talking down on the Xbox One. You do what you do. You go get your Xbox One on. Because, you know, eventually I will get an Xbox One too. But here's my thing. Make sure you go to all your privacy settings, and that'd be like the first thing you do, and make sure you turn off, you disable like a lot of these functions. That'd be like, hey, you want to share this? It's like, no, turn that off. Hey, you want to share video coming from your Kinect? No, turn that off. You know, just make sure when you get your Xbox One on the 22nd, you go into your privacy. Yeah, your privacy, and you disable all the stuff that do not tickle your fancy, because when I get mine, that's what I will be doing. But guys, how do y'all feel about this? How do y'all feel about the Xbox wanting to share your data with the public, with the advertisers, with everybody. Or you're like, Top, man, you're making way too much of this. It ain't all like that. And it sounds quite cool. Or are you like, here we go, X-Bone strikes again. Please let me know in the comments below. I want to know. And make sure to hit that like button if you're ready for next gen. Because, man, it's 5 weeks away. Yes, 5 weeks. I can't wait myself. And don't forget to subscribe to the dog for weekly videos. Help a brother out. It's the one that they call Top Diggity Dog. And I'm out. Deuces.